Greetings. We're going to be discussing cash flow budgeting and the spreadsheet that we have at the Ag Decision Maker that can be used for that purpose. So the Ag Decision Maker is where we have most of the resources that Iowa State University has with regards to farm management. And so we'll go ahead and go to a version of that, but this is what it's going to look like whenever we get to the page that has the 12 steps to cash flow budgeting, C315, that you can see in the middle of the page. Okay, so whenever you are thinking, I want to find something that's on farm management or that Iowa State University Extension has on farm management, you want to go to the Ag Decision Maker. You can remember the URL or you can just Google Ag Decision Maker. You see the image there that's moving at the top of the screen? That's nice to look at. If you go down below, you can see the categories that we have: crops, livestock, whole farm, business development, cooperatives, and renewable energy. We're talking about cash flow budgeting, so that's going to be under whole farm. Under whole farm, it's going to be under financial. And then you can see that this screen looks much like the screen that you saw earlier. And the 12 steps of cash flow budgeting, that's C315. You can see there's a PDF file, and that would be the file that you would download and read to understand that process better. You can see the Excel link. That's the spreadsheet that you would look at, and we're going to go ahead and look at that spreadsheet briefly. All right, so this is C315, cash flow budget, and I told you that there are 12 steps. You can see on this page those 12 steps, and you can see that you can just make that larger so you can read it here. The PDF file that accompanies this spreadsheet is really where I would go for my instructions, but in the spreadsheet itself, you can see that you also have a set of instructions. There's a livestock section, there's a crops section, there's an overhead, capital assets, financing. If you're borrowing money or repaying money, which most of us are in agriculture, then financing is pretty important. The most important page is the whole farm budget. That's where we can see what's happening with regards to inflows and outflows on our cash flow budget. And so as we're going through this process, most important part and the reason that you're actually using this is to see what months we have a net cash flow that's negative, and more importantly, when our ending cash balance goes negative, because that's when we need to have access to operating capital from our lender. And so you can see those two yellow lines: new operating loan needed, and operating loan repayments. Okay, so we went to the Ag Decision Maker, we downloaded that spreadsheet, and we looked at it. Now we're going to talk about those 12 steps briefly. So first, you think, what are my plans? You outline those tentative plans, because of course, we're not in agriculture just to do the same thing we did last year, but there's a reason that we're doing it. So sometimes we're changing things. So what are those plans that I have? What do I have in inventory? Of course, if you don't have livestock, then it's just, what do I have as far as my crop inventory, my corn and my beans, but then also what do I have as far as other inventory pieces that might be sold within that year? And then if you do have livestock, what feed requirements do those livestock have, and what feed do I have available? Because of course, we're going to have other feed sources. We might have some silage, or we might have some hay. We're going to have other feed that we're going to have in that budget. Then we're going to start the cash flow budget, and then we're going to get into the section where we plan our sales of these non-feed crops and excess feed. So, of course, we're not raising that corn to store it for the rest of our lives. We're going to be selling it, and so we're looking at what are we going to sell within the year, and that's going to be, of course, very important as far as generating cash and seeing what our repayment capacity is and seeing if we need to sell a little bit more crop than we did in the prior year. Step 7, estimating that income from other sources. Because when we're talking about the cash flow, we're talking about the cash flow of that farm business, but there may be some other sources that are important from that farm business's perspective. And then the crop expenses that we have, and those crop expenses, we're going to allocate those out. It's not just what is the expense, when does that expense occur? Because that's why you're doing a cash flow budget. These expenses don't all occur in January, and you don't pay them all back in December. Then the capital purchases. Again, we talked about those tentative plans. This may be where when you put those capital purchases in, you look at the year, you might push that off, but you do consider the capital purchases. And then when is my debt going to be repaid? And what are my non-farm expenditures? Of course, this farm hopefully is generating funds that we can use for family living. And so family living is our big non-farm expenditure, but there may be others. And then the spreadsheet itself, as you saw earlier, sums this and provides us with our total cash inflows and outflows. So thinking back, here we are at the particular time period that you're looking at this presentation. For your 2016 cash flow statement, what adjustments did you need to make? Because surely it didn't look as the same as your 2015 or your 2014 and not your 2013 cash flow statement at all. And so what are you thinking about for 2017 and going out into the future? And then for your own farm, if you have livestock, this is a more complicated process. Scale is an important factor. Whenever you're in that spreadsheet and you're looking at the number of acres, you can see that scale does have an impact. And then your land tenure situation, land that's rented versus owned. As you look at those costs that are associated with those different enterprises, you may see some differences there. Custom operations are important. New debt to service or debt that's getting paid off. Cost categories that can decrease, because sometimes when there isn't as much cash, we find efficiencies that we couldn't find before. And then those ARC-CO payments, whenever you're estimating those payments, and there is a good set of tools at the Ag Decision Maker for that, you do need to consider the possibility that those are going to go away, especially as we're looking at 2017, 2018. So again, what changes did you make moving from 2015 to 2016? What were some of the optional expenditures that you found that you had that you could get rid of? And then what's happened with regards to your cash lease rates? As we sit here in May of 2016, the cash lease survey just came out with a fourth year in a row of declines for cash rental rates at the state level and perhaps at your county level as well. Has that been happening for your farm operation? And then when you're looking at your equipment purchases, trades, leases, who's deciding when that occurs? Is the dealer calling up and saying, hey, do you want this new piece of equipment? Or, you know, are you the one making those decisions? And really, I know that you're the one making the decision if you've stayed in this presentation this long, but still be thinking about who has the incentive to get new equipment and what the schedule is. And a really good part of using a cash flow budget is that sometimes we have leakages on our farm. And if we can find where those are and slow them down, that's great. And sometimes also we have these non-traditional sources of capital. And so there might be other financing that's coming into the operation, and that's something that you can pick up with that leakage. That cash isn't there. Where did it go? Oh, yeah, that was a farm expense. Why isn't where it should be? Why is that not where it should be? So the resources that we've talked about, this cash flow budget worksheet, is at the Ag Decision Maker. If you want more information on how farm finances are standardized, the Farm Financial Standards Council, you can see the URL there. You can also Google that and see what resources they have. This has been Tim Eggers with Iowa State University Extension. Thank you for your time.